The galaxy is the Emperor's, and anyone or anything who challenges that claim is an enemy who must be destroyed.
Many of the chapters of the Adeptus Astartes are commanded by chapter masters of great renown. Forged in the flames of legendary conquests, battles of mythic proportions, or acts of great import, or even infamy. Zealous rage, an aspect attributed to many of the ranks of the Space Marines. Yet above all, there is one whom embodies what can only be described as fanaticism in their pursuit of exterminating the ruinous powers and Xenos of the galaxy. High Marshal of the Black Templar Successor Chapter, Helbrecht. To those comprising the ranks of the Black Templars Chapter, it is of no surprise that they would one day be led by their current High Marshal, Helbrecht. Embodying the stubborn, bloody-minded, zealous rage of his chapter, Helbrecht commands his men with honor and unwavering dedication to the Emperor of Mankind's vision. Ascending quickly amongst the ranks of the Legion, Helbrecht would be elected as High Marshal during 989 M41, in the wake of the subjugation of the Xenox of the Sigillaire Nebula. Even during his early years as an initiate, Helbrecht would exhibit courage of abnormal proportions amongst his brethren. His ferocious drive to purge the galaxy of the enemies of the Imperium, an inspiring presence within the Black Templars chapter. Deeds such as standing his ground against a swarm of Tyranids at the Battle of Death Core Ridge, embellishing his indomitable will. Serving his chapter as a neophyte during the Vinculus Crusade, under the command of then High Marshal of the chapter, Ludoldus, Helbrecht would face the Chaos Death Cults on the planet, alongside the Inquisition and Sisters of the Battle Order of the Bloody Rose on the planet of Pelerigon V. Inducted a decade thereafter into the chapter's Sword Brethren, due to his legendary mastery of the blade while slaying a demon prince of the ruinous powers, Helbrecht would be drafted into a new crusade under the command of Marshal Dydin. The crusade would wage for decades, with Marshal Dydin falling in battle. Helbrecht would be promoted to the rank of Marshal, and with furious zeal, command the remainder of Dydin's crusade. Records of Helbrecht's glories unrecorded until his ascension to the rank of High Marshal, with the death of High Marshal Cordell by a cornate berserker during 990.M41. Unanimously elected by his chapter to lead them, Helbrecht would be presented with their most sacred relic, the Sword of the High Marshals. The embodiment of his chapter's warrior spirit, Helbrecht charges into battle, bellowing oaths of vengeance to the forces of the ruinous powers and Xenos alike. Believed to walk the path set by the Emperor's own hand, the Black Templars follow their High Marshal without hesitation in battle. Striding forth into battle with attendant thralls, one maintains and carries Helbrecht's combi melter, known as Ferocity, whilst the other cleans his blade of the impure blood that stains its edge. Immediately declaring a crusade against the Cyphor fiends of the Ghoul Stars, the Black Templars would wage war in a region of space that no Imperial expedition has ever returned from alive. For 8 years, the Ghoul Star Crusade would see the extermination of the entire Xenos population within its outlying planets at the hands of the Black Templars. Finding no Xenos on their supposed stronghold worlds, the Black Templars would have no time to investigate the dormant planets, for they would be hailed in distress by a besieged hive world crucial to the survival of the Imperium, Armageddon. With all haste, the Black Templars would travel to Armageddon to combat the Orc hordes led by their war boss, Ghazghul Mag-Uruk Fraka, combating the largest Orc war in the Imperium's history since the Ulanor Crusade. The Black Templars would lend their strength to the Third War for Armageddon. Given command of the entire assembled strength of the Adeptus Astartes fleet, Helbrecht would be appointed due to his vast experience in naval warfare. Renowned as possibly the greatest living naval commander of the Adeptus Astartes, leading several boarding actions against the Orc Space Hulks of Ghazghul's fleet, Helbrecht's surgical strikes and bloody engagements would cripple the Orc invasion fleet. With the Orc flagship retreating from Armageddon, Helbrecht would swear an oath to pursue the Orc warlord. Accompanied at the petition of the hero of Hades Hive, Commissar Sebastian Yarrick, the Black Templars would hound the Orc fleet. Cornering Ghazgul's flagship, the Killwrecker, Helbrecht would nonetheless fail in slaying the Warlord, his escape into the warp allowing for his eventual creation of the Great War. Bitter at his failure to kill Ghazgul, Helbrecht would nonetheless have no time to ponder his actions with the Black Templars required to aid the Imperial Ice World of Schrödinger 7. Besieged by the Necron Overlord, Imhotep the Stormlord, the Black Templars would clash against the prepared might of the long-slumbering army of Necrons. Blunted by a series of Necron ambushes, the Black Templars would struggle to gain ground on the planet's surface. Hulled into molten rivers of cryonite, the Black Templars and Necrons would wrestle for control of the battlefield. Therein, Helbrecht would face Imhotep in single combat, killing the foul Xenos a dozen times over, yet watch as his broken body would reforge itself, with its living necrodermis, mere seconds after each deadly strike. Exhausted from the exertion of so fierce a duel, Helbrecht would collapse with scores of wounds to his body. Rather than kill the High Marshal, Imhotep would sever Helbrecht's right hand. A mark of disgrace for what Imhotep would remark as his much-deserved defeat. Rallying to their fallen High Marshal, the Black Templars would retrieve his broken body and retreat from the planet of Schrödinger 7. Swearing an oath of vengeance against the Stormlord, Helbrecht would vow that the next time they would face each other in combat, only one would leave the battlefield alive. An opportunity to cleanse his shameful defeat presenting itself at the planet of Davitas. Discovering Stormlord Imhotep's flagship, the inevitable conqueror, Helbrecht would relish the chance to achieve his vengeance. Intercepting the vessel aboard the Black Templar's battle barge, Sigismund, they would land a crippling blow to the Necron flagship's propulsion array, casting the ship adrift in space. Teleporting onto the Tomb World's bridge, the Black Templars would swarm the Necrons within minutes. Yet the cowardly Stormlord would retreat from his flagship. Enraged, Helbrecht would ensure the total destruction of the inevitable conqueror by setting it on a collision course with the system's nearest star. Reaffirming his oath of vengeance, Helbrecht would not relent in his goal of destroying the Pharaon, no matter the cost of victory. However, with the birth of the Great Rift tearing through the galaxy, the Black Templars would be scattered. Once again mustering to combat the Orc Warlord, Ghazgul, the Black Templars would be interrupted in their pursuit with the arrival of the avenging son of the Imperium, Rabute Gilliman. Presenting the Black Templars with reinforcements of Primaris Space Marines to be implemented by the Chapter, the Primarch of the Ultramarines would remind Helbrecht of his duty and the history of the Blade of Office which he carried. For it is said that the Blade of the High Marshal was forged from a shard of Primarch Rogul Dorn's own blade. Shattered in Dorn's grief at failing to protect the Emperor, the sword is a reminder to all High Marshals to carry it into battle to smite the enemies of the Emperor. With Gilliman's departure, Helbrecht would command his forces to reinforce the many worlds of the Adeptus Ministorum, threatened by the expanse of the Great Rift. Warily accepting the Primaris into the ranks of the Black Templars, Helbrecht has undergone the torturous procedure known as crossing the Rubicon Primaris. Further enhancing his physical strength, Helbrecht is renewed with purpose in his prosecution of purging the galaxy of heresy and traitorous intent to the throne. His many grudges and crusades burning his hatred and zealous fury for the remainder of his command as the High Marshal.
The Emperor extends his will to us when we destroy the wicked and impure to reconquer the galaxy in his name. The Emperor leads the galaxy to righteousness, and thus we must petition for his judgment on the wicked. For it is judgment without mercy.
This has been a tale of the Great Imperium of Man, read by the Remembrancer. Helbrecht's crusade endures far into the 41st millennium. Should any lesson be learned, may it be that of his dauntless resolve. Humanity shall not submit to the will of fell gods, nor the treacheries of Xenos. Alike to the sword of the High Marshals, always remember our duty to the Emperor in upholding and protecting his Imperium.